I forgot to switch my game output. Lil. I didn't even know I was on the other scene. That sucks. Okay, well. Welcome to episode 2, I guess, of this server. I've been playing on here for about almost two hours now. I built a fancy schmanchy little house. I actually need to fix the rest of this, whatever the hell is going on here. I guess the best way to summarize the last episode was I did a lot of stuff for this house. Just getting like resources and stuff just for this house. But I think it turned out great. It's supposed to look very old, worn down. I wanted to make it look as funky and like old as possible, while still having, like, you know, structure and everything like that. So, I just made basically a really old-looking house, and I think it turned out pretty well. That's basically what happened in the last episode. Welcome to episode 2. For episode 2, I wanted to spend most of my time setting up a bigger, better farm. I think what I actually want to do is I want to convert this whole, hillside kind of part, into a pretty decent looking farm. We need to get actually a few farms started. The number one thing that needs to be done here is a tree farm. That is the number one thing. So, this is a zombie here. Living underground is not fun. But yeah, so what I want to do with this area is I want to create a nice, what I'm envisioning here is a nice little water fountain right here. And I want to add a nice tree farm just surrounding the area. So I'm going to go ahead and get started on that. The first thing we need to do this project, this little project, is gather a shit ton of cobblestone. So I'm going to do like a little transition here. See how well that goes. I need iron. There it is. Okay. Transition begin now, I guess. There seems to be a specific input that is actually resetting my scenes. So I think I need to go to OBS for a second and actually fix that before I actually like start recording the rest of this video. Okay, I believe I have fixed the issue with my scenes changing. Okay. At this point, I think I've gathered enough stone. Oh man, I'm having some recording issues, man. The struggle is real. Don't worry about it. Okay. Now that we got the issue of our farm, done, and also, now I've got some of this cobblestone baking, I can finally start getting... Or I can finally get started on working on this little fountain thing that I wanted to do. I'm going to go ahead and swim up here and see if I can block this water source, though, first. Freaking massive water source up here. Yeah. Ooh. One of the issues of building underground are the... massive water sources. Ow. Just broke my knees. I think I'm actually gonna keep this original shape for the actual waterfall. I might make it a little bit shorter though. I'm trying to basically get out like a rough shape of like what I actually want the water fountain to look at. or look like. But it seems like it kind of does that itself in terms of just being so easy to kind of create something with this. Yeah. See? And that would be perfect, and then I'd just have it run down into like some little pockets or something like that. Let's just see how this looks as of right now. I'm gonna grab some water real quick. I guess I'll just grab it from up here and also block up this water source as well. These little water sources are always so annoying. There we go. Easily able to patch it up though, which is very lucky. And just climb up here and place that there. Break that. Perfect. And now, basically, I just try to capture the water the best I can. I think I might have built it a little too big on one side. Also seems to be a little spot where the water doesn't want to flow, which is a little interesting. Okay, I think that does it. And then I'm going to build up a little platform here. Whew! We're finally recording now. I'm just going to say this, like, the first episode is lost or something like that, and just hope for the best. Until I get called out on it and be like, forged, faked, whatever. So, this first little bit is going to be like cobblestone surrounding it. And then the rest I'll put like dirt. So this whole area will eventually be filled with dirt. So, I've got to mine some of this cobblestone up. They're trying to reset the server, but I want to finish my tree farm. My recording is saved! For like 5 minutes. Ugh. So context, they're trying to restart the server because they want to fix quests. As you can pretty much just see from chat. But I really want to finish my, tree farm first. And then I'll tell him when I'm done. And then he can, like, restart the server or whatever. I know I'm selfish, but, you know, tree farm equals, like, life or death, basically. Oh, my God. It's a skeleton with an enchanted bow. I can't die. Not yet. I made this joke in the first episode where, like, if I die on this server, I have to go to a completely different server. I don't know why I made that joke, but I was like, you know, it would be really funny if, like, someone did, like, a series like that. I think it would be really cool, but also, like, hilarious at the same time. Just as a small challenge to themselves, like, oh man, I've built, like, everything on the server. He dies to, like, a skeleton, and then he has to leave, and, like, no one ever hears of that person again. Like, they spent, like, years and years on the server. I don't know why that is such a, like, a funny concept to me. It just is, for some reason. This would be a cool, like, area to act as, like, a lost forest, almost. And, like, I'd put, like, a sword on the fountain or something like that. Kind of like, the Master Sword in Breath of the Wild. I feel like that'd be kind of cool. And then add, like, a little things around. But I don't think this area is big enough to actually do that. So I'd do it on, like, a kind of smaller scale. But I think it would still be, like, an awesome little project. Okay, so now I take 3 away. And I try to build it off of that. And now the only thing I need to do is I need to get my hands on some oak saplings. So I need to take a look at, yeah, my iron hoe is not a good durability. Okay, let's see if I can RTP and see if I can find some oak saplings real quick. It should be easy enough. Okay, never mind. Wow, I just got fucked so hard by this game. It spawned me in a plains biome. Nice. Oh, I heard you needed trees. Here's a plains biome. Brother. I got scammed so hard. That was hilarious. Okay, there we go. Here are the oak trees. Found them. They're all on the other side over here. Okay. Do I have any bones? I also might need torches. Oh, there we go. Now they're starting to spawn. Never mind. It would be a good idea to place some torches down, though. Just real quick. I'll place them behind the trees. My little tree farm is set up now. All I need is a grass block. And basically, this is done. Easy. I really like this little design that I came up with. I'm going to take a screenshot of that for later. That's really nice. Okay. The only thing left to do now is to go ahead and set up my little house, set up some things for it. I gotta think a little hard about this though, because I want to figure out exactly what I'm gonna place here. I think the first thing that I'm gonna go ahead and do, first off, I need a pickaxe. There we go. First thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and place a furnace in front. That's the main thing that I want here. I guess the main thing I could do here is place that furnace down, and then let's figure out how to make a smoker, which I believe you create with logs, if I'm correct. You create it by surrounding a furnace with logs. So let's take that and surround it with logs. No. Smoker. Oh, there you go. Oh, it's 4. Okay. I knew I wasn't wrong. I was like, Okie dokie. And then for a smelter, I can't remember what it's actually called. Blast furnace. You need iron and smooth stone. Okay. I genuinely did not remember how to make that recipe, so I was like, Okay, so I need 3 stone, and I need iron. So I have to wait for that to be done. So that's perfect. And then we can place our smithing table there, and our crafting table can go ahead and just stick in the corner for now, which is perfect. Boom. So I need to take that. I need to take this furnace. I need to go into here, place that, and then the furnace. Here we go. Blast furnace. Perfect. I'm going to go ahead and grab my coal. Turns out I don't have 3 stacks right now, but that is fine. I'll just split it across. I fucked it up. And I'm terrible at splitting coal, apparently. There we go. There we go. And now I can place my food in there, other resources in there, and then iron and stuff like that in there. Perfect. And I think that's it for this episode. This episode was a lot shorter. I'm not gonna lie. The second episode was a lot shorter than the first one that I did, which I fucked up terribly by forgetting to switch scenes. But let's see, how long have I been recording for? 40 minutes. Oh, well, that's probably why it feels like it's been a lot shorter. It's only 40 minutes. But at least that means it's going to take a hell of a lot less time to edit this down. But that is basically it for this this episode. Thank you all for watching. Oh, I also forgot to mention what server this is at the start, but I feel like it would be better if I did this at the end. This server is called, if I paste in chat, luckymcserver.net. So if you guys want to check out this server, here's the actual IP of the server. So go ahead and check it out. Join the server, I guess. It's pretty fun. I spent a little bit on here. I think today I've spent over 3 hours, because my first recording was an hour and 30, and this one is 40. So mostly 3 hours. But yeah, I hope you all have a great one, and I will see you guys in the next episode that I do on this server, this Lucky MC server, also called Lucky Network. Okay, bye-bye.